Dr. James Hamblin is here. He's a staff writer for The Atlantic.
Deaths per day and deaths per day and
deaths per day and
that has become, it's such a large number that we have coping mechanisms to guard against having to deal with that. We become numb, becomes meaningless because it's too tragic to deal with.
And because it's too tragic to deal with.
And so while I think it's important that we keep following the numbers, I think they're proving to be an ineffective motivator for some people to continue caring and continue taking the actions that are needed in order to stop this pandemic, which we need to remember is entirely preventable.
Situations where the man happened to have a heart attack. It wasn't related to the vaccine. But when news outlets put up entire stories about it, can be kind of scary, James.
It absolutely can. And as you know, journalists are obligated first and foremost to present the facts and tell the truth. But the ways in which certain facts and certain stories are highlighted will shape a narrative, a public narrative. So right now there's a lot of demand for the vaccine, and that's great. But as the supply grows and grows, we're going to see people who are coming into the option to get vaccinated with certain feelings and opinions about the cost and benefit to themselves, and they're being molded right now in a very delicate time by certain outlier anecdotes where people appear to have had allergic reactions or a bad coincidence, like you mentioned, and we're not mentioning the many, many, many people individually who've had fine experiences.
A logistical challenge like that.